Many say this generation is China's space travel generation. Taking inspiration from their country's space program, in the eastern port city of Ningbo, high school students are making their own satellite.
10年前吧，我们跟他讲卫星社，我们学生就说卫星社，那卫星在哪里啊？我在一个学校里面可以自己做一个小小的航天的这个卫星的设计师啊，他是不敢想的，因为无论从硬件条件还是软件条件都不允许。
3 years ago in 2019, the children's first self-made satellite rode on a rocket into space. It went beyond many people's imagination. And it sent back these photos. Teaching in this school for over 20 years, Le Tian Shu has seen generational changes.
In 2011, the U.S. passed a law effectively eliminating the possibility of China joining the ISS.
The U.S. hadn't banned China from the ISS.
Yeah.
Maybe China wouldn't be trying to make its own competing space
station. 沃尔夫条款以后，我那时候就告诉他们，美国人不跟我们合作了，是他们退步了，我们进步了。为什么？他们现在不跟我们合作，怕我们学嘛。那么一个民族如果怕别人学的话，那么他就是什么？是老本。
11 years after the Wolf Amendment, China's space station has been already orbiting the Earth. That also makes this small satellite club dream even bigger.
未来我自己其实希望就是投身航天这方面的事业，但是现在我个人觉得还是留在国内，因为我觉得有些东西，包括航天技术之类的。 如果你是出去的话，包括美国对我们现在一些技术限制，我觉得可能学不到最好的。我们看得见我们航天史背后的那一片艰辛，再到现在我们自己的空间站建立了，包括我们自己做的这颗卫星，我们现在的想法也是将它从空间站抛出去。